It's Saturday, the 28th of January, 2017. Well, it's very nicely warmed up outside, I must say. After a few days and nights of extreme cold weather. My God, the other day I was coming home, -3. And you get out the car, don't you, and that cold air rushes in. Mind you, I need a bit of air in the car. Unfortunately, a little bit of a glass of beer was dropped over my one of my cases that I carry around stuff in. And yes, and I did thought that I'd cleaned it all up with the spray and that. Anyway, I've just been down to the car today. I had to get my laptop out to do something. And it stinks of beer in the car. Oh, it's awful. You don't mind so much if you're going to a pub somewhere like that, you know, but in your house or in your car, something like that, it stinks of beer. So I think what I'll have to do is I've got to work tonight. I'm doing Kelly Kim's 30th birthday party, which involves a lot of karaoke, hopefully. And that's in Sydenham this evening. That's a little private party tonight. So when I've done that, I think tomorrow, I've got a day off tomorrow. So I'll probably get the case out and give it a really good clean. I hope it hasn't gone inside the case because that'd be a bit more difficult. You know, if it's got onto the material. Mind you, I could cut the material out, couldn't I? Because that's not really required in there, as long as it's an old plastic case with bits and pieces. So I'm running quite a little bit behind today. So a little bit of a shorter show today. I know you're disappointed. I know you are. A little bit of a shorter show today. Is it too much green today? I don't know. My stomach is getting bigger. And it's just my stomach. That's why the shirt, you can't see it, can you? Now, if you was able to see below here, I would have had to put a larger shirt on. But it's kind of open there at the It's kind of open there at the bottom a little bit. And this was fitting a few weeks ago. My niece bought me this for Christmas. Yeah, honestly, so there we are. I popped down to the doctor's yesterday because I've got this ongoing stomach trouble, as you know, well know. And they're going to put a little scan thing over that side. It's down here. I'm not going to get up because you'll be resting my tummy. It's down here to here. I lay that way, and it feels sometimes like you're laying on something. Not all the time, but in particular, the last 2 weeks, it's been particularly bad, and you can't blooming get comfortable. It's okay when you stand up. It's only when I lie down, or if I'm sometimes sitting in the car, then it's at the back. Sometimes it's at the front, sometimes at the back. So you're going to send me down to a scanner thing. Apparently, one of those things like what pregnant women have. My mate says I've got a parasitic twin growing inside me with real hair and teeth nibbling away at me. And that's what the pain is. So that's what I'm going to have done. So we've got an appointment to do that. I've also got an appointment at the... It's all appointments. Is this what you get as you get older? All these appointments. I'm getting fed up going to hospitals. Got a hospital thing here to have a look at my stomach as well. So we'll see what's what. And I shall keep you fully informed of any activities that are happening in my medical life, OK? I've been a very good boy yesterday. I have purchased my TV licence. Da-da-da-da-da-da! TV licence is here. £145.50. Now, I can hear you now. Oh, that's wicked. They shouldn't be paying that. And I bet you've all got Sky subscriptions, haven't you? That is not bad. All that BBC for £145.50. How much is that a week? So that's about 15 pounds a month. That's not bad, is it? 15 quid a month, would you say that? It's something like, no, it's not that, is it? 30, 60, 90. 120, 50. No, it's nowhere near that. 30, about 20, 20, 25, 25. I don't know. Whatever it is. Whatever it is. It's not bad. And I know a lot of you have got this Sky subscriptions and all that. I have no subscription television in this house. I used to have the lot when I lived in my flat in Wandsworth. Mind you, I mean, there weren't the amount of channels there are today. But I used to have the Sky and the BSB. I had two dishes on my... I was the only flat with two dishes proudly displayed on my back wall. And I used to have all that. And then I realised I wasn't watching anyone. I moved here. Now, where did I cancel it? There or here? I think I cancelled it here. I had it here for a while. And then I realised I wasn't watching it, so I cancelled it all. and I refuse to pay for subscription telly. I've got no Netflix, nothing like that at all. And I was looking at the Sky packages. They're not cheap, you know. And where is my calculator? One moment, please. I shall just go and get my calculator. I can usually do this stuff in my head. But my brain is not functioning properly this morning. I look so untidy today, don't I? My brain is not functioning this morning. So £145 and 50 pence divided by 12 months. So that is £12, 12 a month. £12, 12 a month gets you all the free TV that you could possibly want. £12, 12 a month. But the Sky is, I think it's hideously expensive. I really do. You've got the original bundle, which I've bought up on my computer system. The original bundle is £20 a month. Now, I'm going to tell you the prices after the special offer. Because generally, you get so much off for so many months. For example, you can have it £10 a month for 6 months. That's still another £120. Remember that. £20 a month is going to cost you £240 a year. Now, that's just the original bundle. 35 entertainment channels, catch-up TV, and that's it, really. 240 free-to-view air channels. Now, remember, I've already told you, I have the 240 free-to-air channels are probably the same ones as I can get. I have FreeSat and FreeView. Are you wasting money on something you don't need? I bet there's some of you watching this now who have got all these channels and you never watch it. Either you watch the free ones or you're out somewhere gallivanting, dear, possibly at one of my free-to-go-to karaoke nights or quiz nights. Then you can have the movie bundle. Oh yes, that's where you get, I think, all the films. 35 entertainment channels, 11 Sky Movie channels, Sky Movies Disney, more than 1,000 movies on demand, chance to see new films before online, subscription services, 11 free-to-air HD channels, 240 free-to-air channels. Now remember, once again, the free-to-air channels are free anyway. You don't need a subscription. That's going to cost you £37 a month. I think that's hideously expensive. Let's just work this out on my Casio FX39. Very ancient calculator. One moment, please. So £37 a month. How much is that? That's over a year. That's £444. Remember what I told you before? TV licence, £145.50. Now, you've got to have that anyway, right? And then add on another £444 on top of that if you go with Sky Movies. Want more? Well, there's always the family bundle. That's £36 a month, so it's a pound less. Now, what's missing out of that? I don't think that's the films, that one. No, it's not the films. You don't get the films on that. The sports bundle, I think, is possibly the dearest one on its own. Now, there's no films in that one. No films. But if you're a sports fan, you're going to have to shell out £45.50 per month. Over the year, shall I tell you? £546 a month. Over half £1,000 a year to watch the sports ones. Or maybe you want the lot. How much do you think it costs for the lot? Eh? So you get everything. Sports, films, the whole lot. £75.70 per month. So if you want all the channels, and I'm sure a lot of you have got them, £75.75 a month, hang on, £75.75 a month will cost you over a year £909, almost £1,000. So these people who say that's a lot for a TV licence, who have got Sky, I don't think you know what you're talking about. I really don't. £900 a year to watch Sky? I don't think so. Let me close that down immediately, as I have no interest. Of course, I think they do bundles, and it comes with you know, telephone line and broadband and all that, but it's a hell of a lot of money, and that's why I won't have it. They're making a fortune, these TV people, especially out of the sports, because of course I think most of us are of an age to remember when it was all free at one point. We could just turn on the telly. My dad would have the telly on blooming Saturday and Sunday. Oh, watching endless amounts of football. And it was all free. ITV, World of Sport, Grandstand on BBC One. And then somehow, some people got greedy. Not you or me. These telly people got greedy. And they started offering money to the football clubs. And the football clubs, of course, they went to the highest bidder. Because it's all about money. And not I don't think it's about entertainment anymore. It's all about money, isn't it? Anyway, no subscription telly for me. So when I pay that £145.50 for that licence, doesn't sound too bad for me now, does it? Right? Some messages on yesterday's show. Alan loved the Union Jack jacket that we had on yesterday. Alan, thank you very much. As purchased for me by non-Irish Mary from Ireland. So thank you very much for that. Good morning to Timmy. Hello, Timmy Thomas. Timmy Thomas, who says, funny watching you deal with Ross Patdelt. Oh, yes. Ross rang up yesterday when we were doing one of our live shows. And he didn't know what he wanted to talk about. I'd been sitting here talking for half hour. Then he rings up and says, what shall we talk about? Well, preferably one of the subjects I've been talking about. Oh, what have you been talking about? They didn't have any idea what the hell he wanted. Aren't some people strange and mysterious like that? They really are. And you also replaced one of the words in my previous comment. Of course. Of course it was a rude word. This is a family programme, dear. We can't have rude words being iterated on this show. Thank you very much. Good morning to Alan, who also liked the Union Jack blazer which I wore as well last night to the karaoke. We had a lovely karaoke last night. Lots of new people coming along there. So welcome to you all, boys and girls. Simon says, I went to... No, it's another joke. I'm not going to read your jokes anymore, Simon. I'm fed up seeing jokes. Simon says, you and Ross on the phone from Norwich. That is the funniest thing ever. We love the conversation. And Simon also says, you wouldn't freeze Chris at the comedy club. I don't want to do the comedy club. It's not something I would do. It really is. I don't know why you're going on and on, Simon, dear. You're like a bloody old woman in a shop. On and on and on. Shut up. Simon came along to one of the karaoke's the other week. Oh, my God, he's loud. You think I'm loud? He's sitting in the pub in the audience. The entire crowd can hear his conversation with people. On and on. Simon says, you wouldn't freeze at comedy club, Chris. And yes, do the bleh, bleh, if they don't laugh. That's brilliant if you wanted to do that. It would help you. I would help you with scripts and things. No, not interested. I'm not interested in doing comedy club or anything similar to that, my friend. All right. In the news this morning, of course, Prime Minister Mother Teresa has now met Mr. Trump. And this morning, I turn on the telly this morning, she's in Turkey meeting the bloke there. Now, what's his name? Turkish President Recep Erdogan. Erdogan. And she's there already. How does she do that? Oh, I don't think I could be a prime minister. It must be very, very tiring flying from place to place as rapidly as that, don't you think? Could you do that? Oh, no. And did you see Donald and Theresa? They were holding hands. I hope he didn't start touching her inappropriately. I would be very, very disappointed if he started anything like that with Mother Teresa. Because we love Teresa and the shoes. We do. So she's over there today. Is it like a world tour she's going on at the moment? I don't know. But I don't know how you would keep up with all that travelling. I hate travelling. Going on planes does my head in, that is. I haven't been on a plane now for a couple of years now. I think the last time was to Israel. That was about a year and a half, 2 years ago now. Yeah, I can't be dealing with the flying. Does my head in. Hanging around at airports and passport control and blooming security this and security that. Oh, can you put your seatbelt on? Oh, just gets on my nerves. So, no, I'm afraid the airline industry, you've lost me as a customer, what with all your delays and all that. I'm sure I'm not the only one as well. Now, I'm glad to see this. Drivers who use handheld mobile phones should have them confiscated as a blunt and brutal deterrent, urges police chief. And I agree with this. I'm sick to death of driving along roads only to see someone... I mean, it's bad enough like that. That's bad. But some of them are texting, dear. They're working the phones as they're going along or reading a newspaper. I've seen it happening. I saw one bloke watching the telly. Watching the telly on his mobile phone. And this police constable, Jane Willits, Rhodes policing lead of the Police Federation of England and Wales, said British legislation is behind the times and they need to be confiscated. I totally agree with that. I totally agree with that. If I had a pound for everyone that I saw using mobile phone, you got hands-free. I mean, how cheap is a hands-free set now? Mind you, you've got to get a good one. I've had bad ones of those. Mine's built into the car now. You can buy them. I wouldn't buy a cheap one, though, because it's pointless. You can't hear it, and you're going to pick up the phone, aren't you? You know, so, yes, I totally agree with that. What do you think? Anything? And we do seem to be going backwards at the moment. I've noticed that. There's a bit of a resurgence in the purchase of vinyl records. Now, as a DJ for many years, I played vinyl, and then I went on to CDs, and then I went on to laptop and MP3s. Much prefer the vinyl. The touch, the smell as you open a record, that smell of vinyl is just beautiful. Just beautiful. However, I have no vinyl in it. This is the occasional record here and there, I think. I don't know where. I can't see it in here. I dumped most of my vinyl a few years ago. It was taking up an enormous amount of it. And I MP3'd the lot of them and then took them down the dump. Years ago, people have said to me, oh, you should have sold those. Really, they're not worth anything. You know, you've got to have an unopened copy of an Elvis Presley track that only so many were. But they're worth money. The stuff that you and I would have are not worth any money. But it's beautiful to hold this thing, flick through records, not really knowing what you're looking for. You know, oh, I love that one. It's not the same when you're playing MP3s, when you're DJing on them. For a start, everything's in order. Everything's alphabetical, right? And you tend not to go down to the bottom. You play a lot of A's and a lot of B's. And then the stuff at the bottom doesn't get played. It's just the nature of computers, really, I suppose. But much used to prefer the vinyl. Would I buy vinyl again? No, I don't think so, because you can't really go backwards. I wish that I suppose in a way MP3s had never been invented. But then that can't happen, can it? That was not going to happen. MP3s. To go backwards to records now and have to start... Well, I mean, I don't do much DJing now anyway. I wouldn't want to carry around... I used to carry around boxes of the bloody things. Especially when I was doing my mobile discos, you know, weddings and that in the 80s. I had a transit van and the records, I had 10 boxes of little records and they went up to here. And you had to carry them all in and put them all behind you on a table. Now, that little laptop carries thousands and thousands of boxes of records. You don't use all of them, do you? You know, the difference is you would now and again, you would flick through your box of records and take out the ones you didn't play anymore and put them in a box at home and then two boxes and then three boxes and then four boxes. So I don't think I could go back. But some people are buying vinyl now. Now, here's another thing in this morning's Daily Mail. Ektachrome was phased out in 2012. Do you remember that name? Ektachrome? Films for cameras. Kodak is bringing back traditional film due to overwhelming consumer demand. The photographic company said it plans to start selling its Ektachrome film before the end of the year, with others to follow. Ektachrome was phased out in 2012, but among professional filmmakers, there has been a resurgence in sales, Kodak said. The turnaround is the latest instance of old technology coming back because computers don't want to let it go. I know what you mean. We don't, do we? We don't really like this change. I mean, it was a lot more hassle, I suppose, really, when you think about it. Buying film for your camera, wasn't it? You had to put that thing in. You had to pull it out carefully. Not too much, otherwise you muck up the rest of the film. Pull it out and get it. I remember my dad's camera. And he used to kind of, there would be a slot on the end of the film. So you got the long film, you got the round bit there, what holds the reel of film. And you would pull a bit out, unless you had a cassette one where you just drop the thing in. But the 35mm ones, you pull a bit out, there'd be a slot on the end of it. And then that slot would go round or on the spindle on the other side. And you just twist it a little bit, right, just so it's got on, and then close the back door. And then you go click, 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 and it gets to number one, and then you were ready to take photos. And you could take so many, however many there was on there, like 36 or 37. I think my dad sometimes got more than 37 or 38 pictures out of there. I'm not quite sure how he'd done that. And it was very fiddly. And then when it's finished, you know, when it's finished, and then I think he had to wind the whole film back again. And he'd take out the thing, take it down to the chemist, and put it in the chemist, and then 1 or 2 weeks, it could be up to 2 weeks later, you get the pictures back in a little envelope. There was something very nice about that, I think, don't you? I quite like that. We do feel to be going back. I don't think I'd go back to films now. I quite like, I mean, all my photos now are taken on my iPhone. I gave my camera away last year to someone. No point in having it anymore, I didn't think. So I take all my photos, all the films, most of the stuff, this program here, it's all done on the iPhone. And it's only an iPhone 5S. Really? I was going to buy, I've been looking at the other iPhones, you know, we're up to number 7 now, aren't we? The iPhone 7, which I said I wasn't going to buy, but my mate's got one and the pictures are really good. I looked at those, but after speaking to my mate, Ronnie, and my other mate, Adam, now they've both got iPhone 7s, but there seems to be a bit of an issue with where you hold the phone. Now, you would have heard this when Adam calls into the show sometimes when we're doing a live show, and we simply lose his voice. And what they've done is slightly moved the phone, and you can't hear him anymore. And it does seem to be a bit of an issue. I don't know if it's a... Let's have a look at this. Cannot hear caller on iPhone 7. I wonder if it's a bit of an issue. No. Let's have a look. Common iPhone problems. I don't know. Microphone. Microphone on iPhone 7. Problems? Yeah, problem. Let's have a look. Says there's some microphones cutting out. Dunno, no. Anyway, iPhone 7 callers complaining about poor call quality. Yeah, so I've certainly noticed that a few people, when I'm talking to them on iPhone 7, you chat, and then suddenly they go, right? And you say, well, speak into the phone, but they don't believe you. This is the funny thing about it. And they say, oh, well, I haven't moved my head. You have. I can tell you've moved my head. Your head. It's a little bit like this microphone here, right, which is right here in front of me. Now, obviously, you know, iPhone 7 is only going to move slightly because it's only small. But this microphone, look at the difference. If I put it suddenly up here like that, you can't hear me as well. You can still hear me. You can't hear me as well. And it's the same with the iPhone. What they do is they move it, you know, either like that or like that suddenly, and you completely lose what they're saying, and it's so annoying. So I decided on that basis, I'm not going to buy one, not going to get one. I'm considering an iPhone 6 or the other, no, what is it, the iPhone SE. I think Shania has got an iPhone SE, and she has no problems at all with that, and it would just give me a little bit of a quicker way to make the videos and all that. All right. So, Kodak, I wonder if you'll be buying films, will you? Do you quite like that idea, or have you moved on? I don't think I could buy films again, not for a camera, or indeed a video recorder. You know, I've got a video camera there, that's got a hard drive in it, though. You know, you used to get those little tapes and slot them in there. And I had an automatic, not automatic, but it was like the door would close. You push the button. I quite like automation like that. I like automatic doors in my house, like on Star Trek. That'd be quite good, wouldn't it? Let's do today's birthdays, boys and girls. Happy birthday today to Matt Walker. 32 today. Very, very good friend of mine. I worked with him in two places, actually. Bluesh's in London Bridge and the Mayflower in Rotherhithe. 32 years old today. Happy birthday, Matt. Be nice to catch up with you sometime, my friend, all right? Steve Birch today is 50 years old. Phoenix Dawn, 47 today. Arcelia Lynn is 32. Kerry Cook's birthday. Alan Brewer, happy birthday, Alan, 65 today. Stephen Meacham, 41 years old today, in a very butch-looking vest this morning. Happy birthday, Stephen. Lindsey Goslin, it's her birthday. And Brian Newton, who does some radio. Now, what station are you on? Let me have a quick look, see if I can see here, Brian. Of course, Venture Radio. And there's a picture of your setup there, which looks rather good. I'm very pleased. It's had a little... Is that a CD deck there? Oh, nice to see you still having the CDs there. Happy birthday to you all, boys and girls. Here's the song. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. Have a nice day, boys and girls. Thank you very much for watching and listening. I'll see you again.